plane onto your skateboard. It's time to shred back into action.
Welcome, Hahaya Comeback YouTubers. Hope we didn't keep you hanging for too long. Hahaya long in the first half of this swell ghost video. And yes, I said we. You all remember Becky from the first half of our story. Well, she is now accompanying me on said mission to find the main protagonist of this swell Nicktoons show. Ha ha ha.
Well, Miss Maple Leaf, if you're done putting the fourth wall in a lucha stranglehold like my various victims slash love partners, why don't we tell the audience where our next destination is going to take place, eh?
Oh, why yes, of course, Becky, my newest sick fuck pal. I was just getting to that. And without further ado, let's get back to it already. Now then, our next destination will be Flores Park, and when we get to said park I will notice Hector's old Italian friend Vito, who was mentioned in the first half of this video by his hidden established nephew Frankie Falzoni from House O's, along with his two weenie dogs Big Tony and Little Sal. And seeing those two literal hot dogs will remind me of a dog-shaped dildo that I had stashed away in my locker back at Cosmos High, and I will start to get all horny again, and so I go over and take both weenies and cram them in my oven, and it sounds like hey 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 hey, we're gonna have us a good old-fashioned weenie roast. Hey 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 hey, my vaginal juices make the best cocktail sauce. Hey hey hey.
Oh, you know, I'd say that this is something you don't see every day, but then again, this is a speed pony of video, so forget about it.
Looky here, Sandra, I just found my sexy love pet dog Marlo. Why don't you pull those two weenie dogs out of your snatch and get yourself some real doggy style action by going a round or two with this big fella?
Marlo? Oh yes, he does indeed look like a strapping handsome big fella. Alright. In fact, I think I'm gonna jump back into full echo mode and have myself a rip-roaring sexy rape rumble with this bully of a bulldog. Yes.
You do that, and meanwhile I'll be right here masturbating to the whole swell scene. Go on, boy. Show this fiery redhead Canadian what GLC dogs are really made of.
Bort.
I love that dog.
Alright, Marlo, you literal sexy beast, it's time to let this cat out of the bag and into your muscular but slender colon. Hey 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 hey, big doggy speed rape. Hey 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 hey, when it comes to cooking hot dog anus, I'm definitely the cat's meow. Hey 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 hey, cats and dogs fucking together. Mass hysteria. Hey 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 hey, not to mention sexiness. Hey 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 hey.
Oh baby, this is even sexier than I pictured it in my head. I could sit here and watch it all day and hold on. Is that who I think it is over there? Sandra, stop humping Marlo for a minute and look.
Oh, why did you interrupt me, Becky? I was just about to unleash my curdled cat's milk into Marlo's doggy bowl before you. Hey, wait a minute. It's her. Oh yes, it's Ronnie Anne, in all her swell glory. Bad just to look at her go, Havaya. That's right, Ronnie. Fucking do it. OHE double hockey sticks, she has got the sickest sporting skills I've ever seen in a Latino Yankee. Oh baby, I can't wait to get her indoctrinated and the two of us will be a great skater duo in the Darkwing Den. Bad, that is such a swell concept, I just want to masturbate to the sexiness of it until I splooge all the love fluids I have accumulated through with this entire
Ahem, excuse me, Miss LeBlanc, I hate to interrupt your joy boner, but Ronnie Anne just left the park and is now headed in that direction.
What's that? You say Ronnie Anne just left the park? Damn, I knew I should have went over there and introduced myself rather than get caught up in a self-indulged ramble. Erg.
Yeah, well, we can still catch her if we hurry. Judging by the direction she was headed, I think I have a pretty good idea where she's going to next.
Well then, we have no time to waste, my blonde Yankee friend. Lead the way.
You got it, Sparky. Let's get to it.
Special thanks goes out to DJ Swell69 for providing the next swell scene for this section of the video.
We will follow Ronnie Anne over to the Great Lakes Area Rapid Transit, or GLART for short, an underground rapid train station which is where the cast of the show usually gets around throughout the series, and hopefully we'll be able to find—
Hey Sandra, I see her. She's getting on the train over there.
What? Already? Well then, come ha ha ha, come on then Becky, let's hurry up and get on there before it OHE double hockey sticks. It already took off. Erg, today is just not my fucking day, but hopefully both the day and the fucking will go for the better soon enough, ha ha ha.
Hold on, I hear another train coming this way and wow, what the fuck? Sandra, there's someone else over there standing right on the track far in the tunnel. He must be really suicidal or something.
Suicidal, you say? Well, as much as I'd like to talk that sorry case out of his plight, I'm afraid we're in a hurry and have to catch this next train, so we'll just give him our best. Hey, wait a minute, that guy looks familiar. Is that?
Hey my fair dinkum ha 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 dinkum sexy faggots, my name is Rodney Blowjobs Perfect, and I am here in Great Lakes City to shove one of the trains from the Great Lakes Area Rapid Transit, or GLART, up my gaping arsehole and use it as a dildo. Yes, I know it seems kind of random, but since my swell masturbation mentor, Drew Pickles, has shoved a 5 series sink and some up his bum in one of DJ Swell 69's earlier videos, I figured that I can emulate the swell process myself. Well, in a small way. I'll start off by shoving a run-of-the-mill subway car up my poop chute, then work my swell way up, maybe take a cum shot at the experimental E956 series Alpha X Sinkinson with enough practice. While I'm in Great Lakes City, I might pay a visit to that sexy wetback college professor Carlos Casagrande, as he almost looks like he could be a Latino relative of my aforementioned love guru Drew Pickles. But enough of this fourth wall demolishing ramble, I hear a train coming fa-fa-fa coming down the track, so I better get my arse all ready for the big impact like I like trains I wish in Nigeria, where Melvin was here, since chaps are really into their trains like I got a train in me Thomas the Tank Engine for the 801 Union Pacific Big Boy all these sexy train references are giving me a big boy speaking of train reference here comes the Sydney trains such a shame that I'm smearing Sydney trains on something as efficient as Clark hey, as my crocodilian bum buddy Jazz would say, that was a ripper.
What the fuck? What the fuck? What the fuck?
Dan Rodney, I would say that this is something you don't normally see every day, but then again this is a Spiaconia video, so who are we kidding? Hahaha.
Oh, why, if it isn't Sandra LeBlanc of the Darkwing Den, wasn't expecting to see a canuck like yourself so far from Cosmos High School. Anyways, if you were wondering, I was just in a swell Latino-inspired Loud House spin-off to turn the Glart station into the Short station. Too bad you're not the manager, or am I?
Oh. Okay. But seriously, when have you ever seen a subway not filled with bodily waste, Rahaya?
Yeah, especially when it happens to come out of yours truly, wink.
What the fuck? Since when is Helga Pataki a character in this Nicktoon series, and why did they give her a blue dress rather than her trademark pink with a matching bow?
Actually, Rodney, this so happens to be a Great Lakes local resident by the name of Becky Blickenstrafer, or at least that's her full name according to the Spiaconia/GoAnimate/YodGetsGrounded community anyway.
Yeah, I guess for all tints and purposes I'll take that last name for these kinds of videos, not that it's gonna help the fourth wall in any way. Moreover, I have heard all the rumors about me being Helga Pataki's secret love child, ha ha ha.
Oh, so then you're the infamous Becky that I've been hearing so much about during this rape journey. Rumor has it that you took a trip down to the land of lovely locks during the Dubster's last goes to video, where I heard you stuck 69 dozen dodgeballs up a Tasmanian devil's arsehole, and then smoked a whole pack of Winnie Blues out of your pee-hole from the monster cock. I also heard that you had.
Well, I don't know anything about a Tasmanian devil, but I did stick a bunch of dodgeballs up a hairy thing's ass, and that whiny little blue thing got pretty smokin' but hurt to learn that I had a monster member just before I stuck her into the one eye-hole that it had for sure. Wink.
Oh sweet pupils, she said I whole while mentioning a monster cock. Plus look at those two nightmare fueling ocular bulbs. Bag, marry me Becky.
But anyways Rodney, I teamed up with Sandra to try and catch my classmate Ronnie Anne, who we just missed on the previous train.
Yeah, we were just about to follow her on the next train before we seen you shove it up your arse as a dildo.
Well, I'm so sorry to inconvenience you, ladies, and I wish you to the best of luck in your little mission to find the main protagonist of this swell but sadly short-lived series. But I need to get my arse down to Royal Woods and find that sexy Uncle Chocolate Clyde McBride and his two dads so that I can give them some of my Royal Wood. Ahemata.
Oh, loaders, I know that was a dig at our hometown and all, but I really need to give you some props for that swell zinger.
Yeah, dude, and I know you don't really dig do dats and all, but since I'm a hermaphrodite, perhaps you'd like to make an exception and take a rock and ride on my rod. Knee. After all, you said you like trains, so you'll be going off the rails on my crazy train. Wink.
Get it?
Okay, there's beginning to be one too many erg ladies around here for the stinky knife agate. Now I'll just once again make like my second daddy, Drew Pickles, and do a pocket rocket jump all the way to Michigan for my next sex destination like as Elf Elkhorn keeps saying, time to flex. That last fair deacon bonds as well.
Heh, just look at him go. Anyways, we might as well take this poopy cover train to our next destination, as it's a lot better than staying here with the rest of these rando minor characters in this subway station, am I right?
Oh, and why not? After all, a little anal mucus never hurt anyone, And I'm sure you loud ladies won't mind either since you were sidetracked from your own rape mission again, ha ha ha.
Oh yeah, we would so love to get back on track so to speak with you two fabulous dudettes, alright. So long as you kept us entertained with those rockin' digits of yours below the belt, wink.
Yeah, just something to keep us occupied so that we don't get all aboard. Sorry, but I couldn't resist.
Yeah, and because you didn't resist, me and Sandra are gonna give you two a sweet, fantastic time for sure. Right, Sandra?
Oh, for sure, Becky. Luan Loud, I would be more than happy to stick my striped sock-cladded hockey sticks down your juicy wet sink hole until the fabric and fibers literally tickle your fancy ha-ha.
And speaking of tickling, Miss Rockstar wannabe, I would just love to take that mighty axe of yours and stream my silky smooth flesh nuggets around those heartstrings before I gave you the most intense but gratifying soul scrub you ever felt. You won't be walking right for a week. Wink.
Oh dude, I sure hope that the fan theory of you crossing over on our series is true, Beckers. Cause yeah, I'd like to have me some more of that.
Hey there folks, all aboard the poo poo choo choo.
Well, you heard the man, ladies. Let's get this literal love gravy train a rolling, ha ha ha. After we get out of the subway, me, Becky and the two loud sibs who now seem to be accompanying us on our quest will start to get hungry after such a long long trip, and so we will make us a pit stop at Amor's Pizza. Now, Amor's Pizza is one of the pizza restaurant establishments in GLC which appears frequently throughout the series and often serves as the main romantic hotspot for some couples, including Lori and Bobby from the first half of the video, Arturo Santiago and Ronnie Anne's teacher Miss Galliano from the episode Teacher's Fret, the previously mentioned Maria and T-Bone from the episode Date with Destiny, and well, let's just say it's a romantic hotspot and leave it at that. Once we get into Amor's Pizza, we will sit over at a table, and when we go over and sit at said table, we will see a waiter come over to take our order, and he will say with a bored and unfulfilled voice, "What can I get for you ladies today?" And I will make the first order and say that I would like a fantastic Mr. Fox pizza. That is where you cut up the tail of a fox and place it onto a pizza with cheese made from the breast milk of a female fox, and then have said female fox piss onto the pizza to give it that zesty consistency. Also pepperonis made from a fox's penis and or nipples, ha-ha.
Next, me and my literal soul sis will make our order for a moon goat cheese supreme, with extra cheese and Luan anchovies. And when I say moon goat cheese, I of course mean as in my petal cheese, of which I scrape off the bottoms of my bodacious petalage with the bunion scraper. Moreover, I make sure to not wash my feet for days so that a thick greasy layer forms on the bottoms of my sweet skins, and I keep my boots on the whole time just to preserve all that cheesy goodness. Yes.
And rather than using actual anchovies, I instead pick a bunch of long thin sweaty slithers of toe jam that have been marinating between my toes for a week, until they get the smell, taste, and thankfully better than the texture of the real thing, ha ha ha. So yeah, there ain't nothing fishy about this swell dish.
And I will take some of Rodney Perfect's shit that I swiped from the earlier subway scene on our way here, and I will request that you place this on my pizza in lieu of tomato sauce. Also, in addition to Rodney's delicious poop, I will take my love sausage and masturbate vigorously until I drizzle my shemale spunk all over the pizza for the cheese topping. I will then request that the pizza be topped with the pubic hairs of every swell patron, of whom Miss LeBlanc mentioned earlier in the scene before we entered the restaurant, especially the white pubic hairs of that sexy Lincoln Loud, of whom I've actually had the pleasure of getting to know on a biblical level. You know it's because of yours truly that he's now a pansexual. And that's a rumor that you can take to the bank, wink.
But then the waiter's usual bland boring tone will elevate to sheer disgust, and he will say, "I have been pranked in this restaurant with phony orders before, but those have to be the most vilest pizza requests I've ever heard in my entire boring sex life. Now I want you punk kids to get out of here this minute before I call the cops." And with the waiter completely incapacitated from the glare of both me and Becky's own faces, he will back away and take our orders like a good little errand boy. Yeah, the dub man thought he'd do something a little different than the usual chewing out the offender in question whenever a swell character in a ghost video makes outrageous suggestions when ordering a swell dish routine, haha.
Man, and I thought they each had scary looks before, but seeing them both at the same time, talk about two-faced.
I am literally too scared to laugh right now.
And after waiting for what seems like an eternity, like waiting for the next episode of The Loud House to come, ha-haya come out, our swell pizzas will show up and both Lunar and Luan will snap out of their bewildered seats and the naughty noshing commences like om nom 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 nom. Oh yes, I can tell a real foxy mama went into this pizza. Om nom 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 nom. I'm in pepperoni heaven. Om nom 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 nom. The smell of Rodney's shit on Becky's pizza is somehow making this more arousing. Om nom 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 nom. Seriously though, being in this restaurant really makes me wish the show did a follow-up to Date with Destiny. Om nom 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 nom. It's both one of the dubster's least favorite episodes but also one of his absolute favorite episodes at the same time. Om nom 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 nom. The pros and cons of said episode really balance out well. Om nom 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 nom. The biggest pro of the episode being the ever charismatic Ernesto Estrella. Om nom 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 nom. And I'm not just saying that because he's played by that swell beaner comedian George Lopez. Om nom 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 nom. Huh, what the H.E. double hockey sticks was that?
Destino!
Oh sweet Felix, I don't believe my fur-lusting eyes. And just as I mentioned him, the great Ernesto appears right before us, and seeing that flashy feather head decking out his robe, which will remind me of a peacock spreading his sexy plumage, will make me so all horny, and so I will once again change into my female gato form and put this bird in the cat's paw to make it worth two in the bush. Hey, that reference was a bit of a stretch, but I think I made it work. Hey, using your good luck incense as dildos. Hey, oh grant me the good luck to find Ronnie Anne in this video. Hey, swirty in my dripping love cave. Hey, I feel like Artaru Moroboshi on Sadie Harkins Day.
Whoa, like, are you feeling okay over there?
Oh no, I'm fine. For a second it felt like someone was talking about me. That's just the price of fame, I guess.
Okay. But anyways, shall we pick up where we left off before you're out of nowhere sneezing fit?
Oh my, indeed we can, my dear. Carlo Picasso Grande, I've been wanting to get you into my heel harem since your spin-off show began, and now it's time to make that fan web dream a slow reality.
Yes, and with perfect timing too, you can get me fitted fitted into your all even pancake buffet while my boo-bell is still arguing with the wa-bossy in the living room.
Hey,
and
have
it sounds like
hey,
that'll be going as it for a while, ha ha ha.
Oh my, this is sounding all too familiar, isn't it, Yoxaya?
Indeed it does, Akemi, my dear. Perhaps we should just hold off on asking the maintenance lady about fixing the plumbing until she has resolved this.
Hey, did a cutaway scene seriously just happen over my rape session? Oh fucking well, hey, and speaking of fucking well, it's time to end this well fuck by blowing my load all over this sexy Latino Liberace looking motherfucker. Destino. Boom. You just got LeBlanc'd. Bag. Ernesto, you truly were the besto. Ha ha ha.
Oh baby, I'm not gonna lie, that was fucking hot.
Yeah, this was fun and all, dudes, but now I say we cut over to the next swell scene and get our rockin' grooves on.
We will finally get Lunar and Luan loud over to the GLC zoo, and when we get inside we will, tell you what, I'll actually let you the viewers guess what will happen next. Will we, A, finally find Ronnie Anne and end this raid journey earlier than expected, B, meet the rest of Acardnet Alpha and watch them have a big toe orgy with one another, or C, find another conveniently placed callback referenced or cameo because we haven't seen enough of those yet, am I right? Okay, turn in your answers now. Alrighty, and the polls are in. And for those of you who guessed correctly, we will head into the zoo and discover that the dub man has indeed once again used this scenario as an excuse to reuse the environmental quiz screen from Arson Parson Kicks Dr. Machino's butt game as an extra obstacle to overcome in this already dragged glucose to video. Yeah, like that wasn't 100% predictable or anything. So anyways, after the UN Tribunal asks us a pretty trivial set of questions, they will all get super shocked when they notice that Sophia Hadjipantelli's maybe baby, i.e. Becky here,
maybe baby,
is actually amongst the set of visitors, and they start to panic. Oh boy.
Hey there, you literal sexy beasts, remember me?
Oh sweet oath. How could we forget?
Why yes, I do leave a long ha 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 long lasting impression on anyone, man or beast. And speaking of things that are long-lasting, I just slipped on a gum-on edible condom and I'm ready to thrust it into your slender pink colons, So get those aforementioned glens ready, cause I'm about to bust a nut like ha. Oh yeah, baby, you guys truly take it like proper love pets. Ha 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 ha. Feeling the anal blood slide across my meat feels you so natural. Ha ha ha.
Hey, let me on some of the peppers. Oh yeah, baby, the anal blood from you sexy beasties is still fresh. Hey, boy, do I love doing things the hard way.
Nice of you to drop in red. It's always swell to fuck with company.
Well, like I always say, company loves misery. Also, I fuck to please.
Well, using this snake as a dildo for my slender snatch and anus, and having him bite my love sausage to feel his venom flow through my bloodstream is painfully pleasing indeed.
This scaly little gimp also makes for a swell condom.
Talk about a literal trouser snake.
Oh yes, Becky, that is just the kind of swell display of bestiality that my kitty cock so desperately needed, eh?
Oh, how humiliating. Just when we thought we would be over this anal sodomy thing forever, she had to show up and demonstrate the rumor about her being true.
Yeah, and we were really hoping to get us a visit from Akane Alpha so that they would have their panel come from where with us and we could get our usual foot fix.
Well, you quiz bad and dudes don't have to look no further. Cause me and Luan so happen to be members of the very righteous group you were expecting all along. And we would so love to give you furry dudes a most awesome scrub down for sure.
Yeah, just take a few minutes with us and I'll guarantee you won't feel like playing possum.
Get it?
Yeah, and you 16-bit beasties should have told me you were paw pumpers. After all, if you had seen the first half of the video and noticed the sandal-cladded shorts that I was showing off, then you probably would have changed your tunes about me. Ha ha ha.
Oh wow, that's the grandmother looking adorable. Yes.
Oh yeah, fool, that is indeed quite a dessous display of sweet pudelage, alright, ha ha. And yes, folks, it is Iaska Langley PMS for you and welcome, ha ha ha, come to the Great Lake City Zoo scene of the video. Hi.
Oh my, yes, that is quite a nice introduction there for sure, Askate.
Yeah, dude, that's words from the streets.
You know what it is, that's what it is.
So then you must be that Becky girl of whom my Shinji-kun was talking about. He told me that you're the 18th angel, something I thought was only a legend up until now.
18th angel. Oh, that. Well, I think he was maybe referring to the time I gave him 18 simultaneous orgasms when we first met, and I believe he called me his angel of mercy. It's just as swell as it sounds.
Oh wow, 18 simultaneous orgasms, that's amazing. I didn't think such a thing could be possible.
Oh, and I also see that Lana Loud is in Akane Alpha as well. Funny though, I thought that she was a blonde like her twin sister Lola. Weird.
Actually you're mistaking my little blonde dudette.
Yeah, no joke, even though she looks the part, she's actually not allowed.
Get it?
Yes, like those two girls said, my name is Flick and I am from the Australian cartoon called Whack-A-Mole. And might I say it's nice to be meeting you swell people and pixelated animals as well. Anyways, before you showed up I was just fitting in our newest member, her name is Adelaide Chang.
Flick honey, we've been over this and my name is Adelaide. But anyways, it's true. I'm the newest member of Akane Alpha and I will be bringing all my favorite love pets from our swell show into the group's menagerie of bunion beasties to have our swell way with during our private time when we don't have any boys around. Especially not that stinky Carl Corsa Grande who is always picking on me. But I always make sure to get that little homo back by pummeling him senseless with my podophilic martial arts skills. Yes?
Hi, it's true, folks. We've enrolled young Adelaide here into the Anything Goes School of Podophilic Martial Arts and she has been showing a lot of promise in the Dasu ass-kicking department. Why, she might even be as good as our sexy chair lady Akarne-chan. Oh yeah, Bulldoss is very swell indeed, ha ha ha.
Huh, that reminds me. I should probably enroll in the School of Podophilic Martial Arts myself. After all, I'd like to have my little marshmallows to be as deadly as they are adorable like the rest of yours truly. Oh yeah, baby, that would be the fucking business, alright.
Yes, you can, Miss Chinese-American chibi-fied version of the Vocaloid character Cat Hiyuki, Miss Half-German Gynax version of Mikiro Sahina from the Melancholy of Haruhi Suzumiya, and Miss Blue-Dress-Wearing Nicktoon version of Darla Dimple from Cats Don't Dance. It all sounds swell.
Haha, well I see you've met the Series 1 Gina from Crocodoo, of whom we've been pretending to be one of the zoo's newest exhibits just to get an all-access pass for the day. But anyways, before you two ladies showed up, we were also in the process of fitting in another new member to the group. Oh, and I do believe that's one of our other previous new recruits serenading her with a rendition of a classic shonen rom-com hit even as we speak.
Damn it, what kind of piece of shit established? No excuse. I fucked up twice getting here, and now it seems like everyone's already gotten the fit festivities under a hat out of your way. Oh, it's not fucking fair. I just wanted that sexy ostrich show to myself. What's that? You say that you would still like me to personally indoctrinate you into Akame Elf and have been waiting all day for me to do so?
Oh my! That is so romantic!
Hi Shinobu-chan, looks like you'll be getting your chance after all, ha ha ha.
Ooh, I'm finally gonna get my satisfaction in the bird of my wet dreams! Thank you so much, John. I would like to request that while I'm having pleasure you in this little garden, I would also like to use your current boyfriend Sergio as a dildo for my slender snatch and then claw at my shins and thighs with a sexy snake but sharp claws for the host of Angel Pain.
Alright, another good news for Sergio in this swell video and a chance for me to patch things up with Chrissy in the process of Anna.
Oh, well if it isn't that redhead can that came again when she brought that blonde bombshell Becky along with her.
And yes, I've always found you super odd as well since I'm obviously a fleshy. Why do you think I hanged out with the Casa Grande in the first place? Yes.
Hi Becky, why don't you and Sandra Kunsan have a swell to orgy with me and the rest of Akarnet Alpha as long, long as you're here? After all, since it's been confirmed that you are a Futanari like Luna-chan, we could use a little extra sausage to go with our all-you-can-eat pancake buffet. Wink.
Yeah, me and Adelaide would especially like to have us another pedal playmate while we flood this zoo with our foot sweat to make our own love build a bond. Ha ha ha.
Oya baby! That would be so swell getting dominated by an expanded Caucasian G-male dawn like you as a ha-ha!
Well, as tempting as that sounds, my little oriental cutie, me and Sandra here are on a very important mission that requires our undivided attention.
That's right, we need to find Ronnie Anne so that we can complete this raid journey and get her indoctrinated into the Dark Queen Den as part of my personal mission. Oh, well it's actually kind of a funny coincidence that you bring that up, Sandra-kun, cause you see the character in question was actually here not long long ago to look for her bestie Sin while we were getting our pedal party started. What's that? Ronnie Anne was here.
You're fucking kidding. Damn it, we missed her again. Erg.
Yeah, but when she realized my sister wasn't here, she said that she was headed over to the GLC car to look for her there. Maybe if you hurry, you can still catch her before she leaves again.
You hear that, dudes? You still have a chance to catch that rad skateboarding babe. You all better start pumping those kicks and get a rocking move on while the trail is still fresh. Yes.
Well then, what the HE double hockey sticks are we waiting for then? Come ha-ha-ya, come on Becky, we haven't a moment to lose.
Right, off to it then.
Well now that they're gone, I say that we get this pedal party started already. What do you say, ladies?
Hell yeah, let's pump up the pedal jam so that the Amazon shot can be the nasty fucking sick.
Hit it, DJ Carl!
Oh boy, not only are we closing out our scene on something that isn't totally dated at all, but is also not totally predictable. Right, Mr. Coconut?
That's what I was telling you before!
At the GLC Tower.
And so me and Becky will arrive at the GLC Tower, the largest viewpoint of the entire city, and when we reach the observation deck we will start to look for Ronnie Anne amongst the set of patrons and—
Hold on, Sandra. I actually see something coming towards the tower, and— Oh. Sweet. Myself. What is that?
OHE double hockey sticks. No. Fucking. Way.
Why come to your fair patrons of the Great Lakes City Tower? It is I, Taru Morimoshi, and today I am here to give this snow landmark a much needed flossing with my life-sized tender toes and make everyone in said tower super horny ha-ha! Also, I am here with my new girlfriend of whom will be recording the whole thing and posting it online afterwards for epic lolos. Hi!
Okay, everyone, I'm gonna be taking my first selfie next to my newest bunion boost pinky toe. Which, by the way, is actually bigger than yours truly. Yes.
Well anyways, without further ado, I shall now start to climb up the tower so that I can put my pancakes between—
Hold the phone, Artaru, you're rehashing. This is just like when you came Hahaya came to my home country and did the exact same thing to the CN Tower in Toronto, back in one of Pedal Poner 69's earlier videos.
Seriously, what a complete waste of fourth wall demolishing just to make such an obscure callback reference in this already long as hell goes to video. Ugh.
Oh wait, aren't you Becky Chan?
Ah yes, I remember you from that gospel episode and seeing you do the back stroke in that pile of snowmen like they were huge clumps of seed and got me so horny that I masturbated for CJ Street.
Well mama, just look at that big thing. Oh ground me baby, ground me. Wait, I just got me a swell idea. Sandra, you go on ahead and start looking for Ronnie Anne in the tower. Meanwhile, I'll keep Big Boy here distracted by taking a big puff from the smoking cigar he just whipped out on us. Yes.
Oh, I see. Well, I'll just leave you to it then, Becky. Ready or not, Ronnie Anne, here I come, pun intended, haya.
All right, big and handsome, now that we're all alone, why don't I just flip off these flip-flops and use these unblemished velvet pork buns of mine to give that big love katana of yours a fine polishing. Maybe I'll even finish it off with a happy ending by sucking you off. After all, you haven't felt true fellatio until you felt it between the gaps of my teeth as it brushes against my gums. Wink.
Oh my me, having you slide your slender dump-dumplings across my meaty chub, followed by a happy ending? Oh baby, you just made my 4 minutes of love with him and grow an extra mile long with that swell description. No wonder Dubson wanted to re-establish your character and explore your options beyond the vagina.
Oh yeah baby, that was indeed a swell decision on the dub man's part, alright. Now then, first things first, it's time to lose these pesky floppers. Just a heads up, I can actually get kind of rough with my dainty little steppers, so don't be surprised if I start to give you a few kicks here and there as I'm skipping down your yellow dick road, ha ha ha.
Haha, no problem there, Becky-chan. I actually don't mind getting a little rough with my love partners. In fact, it might even help to further drive up my horniness. So let's get you all ready for kick's sake.
Ha ha ha, that's what I like to hear. Alrighty then, tall dark stranger, get ready for me to take one giant leap for manhood, oops I mean mankind, as I do a moon dance on your big lunar rover.
Oh my man, those toes of yours are so fucking smooth. Like tiny little maggots crawling on my cock. Now this is my idea of pubic lice. I can see Dipsy Spider is crawling up my water spout. I hope it doesn't rain anytime soon. Now bring me some of that rough stuff like we mentioned earlier. Oh, 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 yes, harder, harder, oh, yes, harder, harder, oh, yes, harder, harder, than Swellness made you feel. Oh, yes, harder, harder, oh, yes, harder, harder, oh, yes, harder, harder, now I know how few pockets feel. Oh, yes, harder, harder, oh, yes, harder, harder, oh, yes, harder, harder, you seem good enough to be in the school of pocket killing martial arts. Oh, yes, harder, harder, oh, yes, harder, harder, oh, yes, harder, harder, after all those jokes and jokes of yours are people as they attend your school. Oh, yes, harder, harder, oh, yes, harder, harder, oh, yes, harder, harder.
Oh, you're too kind. Now let's give you that promised happy ending with my luscious blowjob lips. Like grr 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 grr. Talk about deep throating. Grr 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 grr. Good thing my gag reflexes worn out long. Ha ha ha. Long ago. Grr 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 grr. Continuing to tickle the shaft of your cock with my little flesh nuggets while I suck you off. Grr 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 grr. Pinching the tip of your penis with said tender toes while I wrap my fork tongue around your vascular head like pinch 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 pinch. Slurp 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 slurp. I can feel the pre-com misting all over my already slippery legs. Pinch 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 pinch. Slurp 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 slurp.
Time for this ring cloud to burst to wash this spider out!
Bag. Now that's what I call a true storm of tropical passion. Hope it was as swell for you as it was for me, big fella. Yes.
Oh, sweet Lilith. I can't wait for Carlotta to log to Lump Sean and everyone else in the heel here about what just happened.
I'm sure we are the Lyoka Warriors and we heard that there was a giant disturbance in this multicultural American metropolis and we are here
Hold on a minute, Ulrich. Is that who I think it is down there?
Why bonjour, my sexy little French fries. Long ha ha ha, long time no see. We?
Oui? Osaka Lilith. It's Becky.
Later that day.
Oh fuck me, I searched that whole damn tower and I still didn't find Ronnie Anne. OHE double hockey sticks, I'm really starting to get fucking frustrated. Hold up Becky, what do you think you're doing?
Oh,
I'm sorry, Sandra. It's just that you said oh fuck me earlier in the sentence and, well, I was actually still a little horny after what I did to that oversized Oriental Casanova back there in the previous scene. Moreover, I am also one of those sex-crazed maniacal speed rape-inspired Speakonia characters who are known for not taking no for an answer. Besides, I could tell you're feeling very stressed out about not finding Ronnie Anne, so I thought I would help relieve some of that tension by giving you some vigorous stress-releasing hardcore sex. After all, I'm the only one in this video that you haven't had your swell way with yet. Wink.
Well, slap my arse and call it the fourth wall. You may have something there, Becky. Maybe venting out some of this frustration is just what I need to get my head back into the game. Ha ha ha.
Ha ha ha, that's the spirit, Sandra. Now get over here and let me put this massive log snake in you. Yes.
Sure thing. And as long as we're gonna do this, I might as well go all out. It's Raffle Demon Rape Session time, baby.
Oh hell yeah, you have no idea how long long I've been wanting to do this. I've pretty much been holding it in for a special occasion, and Becky, if you're not something special, I don't know what is. Wink. And so without any further cock-blocking delays, let's take this newfound partnership to the next biblical level. Hey 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 face is so goddamn terrifying. Hey 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 aha, but it makes my demonic raffle cock go harder the more I see it. Hey 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 hey, those eyes that pierce right into my soul. Hey 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 hey, the fact that you can endure my demonic member is proof alone that you're a bad arse. Hey 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 hey. DW Forever 917 thinks that Becky was a criminally underused and underrated character. Hey 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 hey, if they ever do cross her over into the Loud House to be a rival for Lin Mao Junior like the fans theorize, then that would be fucking swell indeed. Hey 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 hey, it's all in the posts that the dub man made for the Loud House Reddit page. Hey 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 hey, or if they were to do another spin-off down the line, it should definitely be the Becky Show. Hey 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 hey. Now you may think that he's sucking this character's non-existent dick too hard, but it's nothing compared to what I'm currently doing with her in this video. Hey 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 hey.
And speaking of sucking dicks, Sandra, let me give that little meaty devil dog of yours a fine smile. Smothering with my tongue and cheeks like glur 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 glur. I heard a rumor that you're not supposed to put a Raffle Demon's monster member through the oral car wash while breaking the fourth wall. But what's the worst that can happen? Glur 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 glur.
Oh sweet Felix, my cough is literally about to explode.
Oops, are bad.
Well, I don't know about you Beckers, but all that literal fucking around has really warmed me out. I think I'll just pass out for a bit and we can, yawn, continue the search for Ronnie Anne later. You were fucking awesome though. Emphasis on fucking. Night.
Yes, take a load off, Sandra. You've earned it, ha ha ha.
Excuse me, but are you the liar? Judging by all the psychedelic music I heard on the way here, I bloody reckon so. But anyways, my fine Sheila, I have a big meaty joint here with your name on it if you have a big spender to pay for it, and I'm telling you it'll knock your bloody socks off, and this is from experience, wink.
What's that? You say you're selling some wacky tobacco? Well, I just got done smoking two big meaty joints not too long ago, but they say third time's the charm, wink.
Sometime after downtown GLC is restored to normal like nothing ever happened.
Jumping Mario! Jumping Mario! Jumping
hey. Mario! Come on,
Mario, Mario. Who? Who said that?
Oh good, you're awake. I went and bought you a pigeon poop burrito and some cat piss coffee at that new furry aphrodisiac cafe, the Farthingwood Foxhole. Hope you like it, Miss LeBlanc. Ha ha ha.
Huh. Wait. You're Ronnie Anne. Hey Becky, look, we found Ronnie Anne. Our long search is over, haha.
Oh Sandra, your search may be over, but mine is just beginning. I can see so many colors, man. Hey hey.
Actually, I'm the one who found you. In fact, I've been looking for you for quite some time, Miss LeBlanc, and finding you passed out on this spot was very convenient for me indeed.
See, hold on, you mean all this time you were looking for me?
Well, you and my BFF Sid Chong, that is. I've actually been searching all over town for the both of you, but kept coming coming up empty. But then I heard all the sounds of sheer chaos and death when I was headed back home, and so I decided to follow it back to this general area. And here we are.
Holly, great minds do in fact think alike, don't they?
What the, sissy dumas again. And just why are you still here anyway?
But anyways, now that I've found the best skateboarder in all of Canada, I, Ronnie and Santiago of the Casa Grandes, would like to request an application as a member of the Darkwing Den, the most dangerous group of kick-ass vigilantes this side of the fourth wall. I especially would enjoy working alongside you as a swell boarding bruiser, Miss LeBlanc. Oh, see, that would be muy guapo indeed, ha ha ha.
Well, if this isn't the swellest of all coincidences, Miss Santiago, because it just so happens that I've been wanting to find you all day to try and indoctrinate you into the newly formed Latino branch of the Darkwing Den. Such other mucho bueno bad arses in this swell new branch include Ricochet from Mucha Lucha, Manny Rivera slash El Tigre from the other Latino-inspired Nicktoon series by the same name, Marco Diaz from Star vs. the Forces of Evil, and Ronnie Anne would make number 4. Yeah, it may be small now, but we hope to build it up into a truly swell organization dedicated to putting the kibosh on all the prudes and butthurt spreaders south of the border. Yes. Also, I would take you on under my wing as my personal protege, as you so happen to be a bad arse boarder just like yours truly, ha ha ha. But yes, it would indeed be very swell to have you on board, no pun intended, for sure, Ronnie Anne. Wink.
Oh, gracias, Sandra, you have really made my day for sure. Now I can finally kick some major prude butt in one of my favorite crime-fighting Spiaconia groups. Bag, this is gonna be newy swell, ha ha ha.
Hold on there, Ronnie Anne. Have you already forgotten the swell BFF of whom you've also been looking for all day?
Me, Madam Santiago, since you mentioned something about kicking major prude arse across the community, I also have a trait on proposition for you. Whee!
Well, Sid, I just now noticed, that's Sissy Delma. Oh gee, Wawa, could this day get any sweller?
Indeed it could. You see, it just so happens that Adeldum is also planning on starting a Latino branch for the group, and we would like for you to represent it as its proud chairlady, since you are the badass protagonist of this swell series. Also, in addition to yourself, we plan on recruiting the rest of your friends in the Chavez Academy skate team to represent their various countries in our swell group. What better way to show off that Adeldum is a multicultural liberation front, haha?
Not only that, Ronnie N, but being in La Del Don means that you and I will be permanently joined at the heel. And you'll get to touch and fondle my foot with the Abe Lincoln birthmark anytime you want. Won't that just be swell, ha ha ha?
Holy guacamole, a chance to be permanently joined with my BFF Sid, along with my favorite Code Lyoko character. Oh, pinch me, this is like a wet dream come true. And considering whose daughter I am and the family we come from, you probably guessed that I have some pedophilia in me. Moreover, I give great foot rubs, by the way. And the idea of getting to fondle the sexy smooth bare feet of my aforementioned BFF and Frenchie foot idol is so mucho grande that it bears repeating. Also, I heard that Otto and Reggie Rocket have recently joined La Del Dun as well, and getting to know those two Nicktoon legends on a biblical level would also be newly swell in the bargain. So you can definitely count me in as one of your newest recruits for sure, Miss Delmas. You won't be disappointed.
Owie, we were so hoping we would get you, Madam Santiago. Another meal more for all my mon amis. Ha-ha. Hope you don't mind sharing your Miss LeBlanc.
Oh, why of course not, sissy. After all, what's a little shared membership between friends? And we are friends, am I right?
And speaking of sharing between friends, Sandra, I think it's... Oh boy, here we go again.
Oh my god.
Wow, and I thought that Yoon Kwon was fucking sexy.
And yes, that Rappy Mon does have quite a physique, hasn't he? Moreover, if you're wondering why that Radicles guy from the first half of the video isn't here with us, it's because him and some blondie Jack from a 90s anime is busy recruiting my bendy elephant Johnny BFF car into our super lead subdivision of awesomeness as well. But anyways, sis, I think it's gonna be kind of swell that you and I will also be representing the same group, considering that I'm in the Rappy Republic.
See, Rocky, I'm sure you and your rough and tumble soul sibling will indeed make fine representatives of our new Latino branch,
But let's not forget to put credit where credit's due. None of this would have even been possible if it weren't for one small person. Hit that right. Let you share.
Finally, I was wondering when everyone was gonna get back to me. Oh, and Ronnie Anne, from now on, we're gonna be even closer classmates than ever. I so can't wait to know you more biblically as well, ha ha ha.
Wait, Becky, you mean to tell me that you were working with Sissy this entire time?
Oh, more than that, I can assure you, Sandra Cher.
But just quit say, Becky, you mean you didn't tell her?
Yeah, given all the rumors, I figured she would have known all about you by now.
Well, to be honest, I actually wanted to get to know Sandra a little better before going into personal details. And after getting to know her inside and out both figuratively and literally, I think now would be a good time for the big reveal. Yes.
Know me inside and out. Big reveal? Wait, you don't mean...
That's right, Sandra. I was featured in this video to be more than just a mere one-time team-up with La Del Dunn. You see, I happen to be the leader of their newest subdivision.
What a twist!
But yes, it's true. I am the proud chair lady of the group's newest league of rough and tumble badasses, bullies, and athletic bruisers. And I call this badass new subdivision the Becky Brigade. Yes, the Becky Brigade is La Del Dunn's new strong front who helped take on the group's more intense foes, like members of the Anti-Foot faction and the Dark Mares, and the recently relevant again Mega Barney Bunch, including their own subdivision the Mega Duck Nasties, of whom are the Becky Brigade's personal rivals. Other such members of this subdivision include my rarely seen twin brother Ricky, our dog Nova from earlier in the video, my previously established girlfriend Dodge and the rest of her dodgeball team, and girl Jordan from the Loud House. Members outside this franchise include Debbie from the Great North, Buffalina Swolinski from the Proud Family Louder and Prouder, Frankie Ducky from I Got a Rocket of whom we just brought back with Tracy McBean's Deadly Animator, Twister's older brother Lars Rodriguez from Rocket Power, Shelly from South Park, Maya and the rest of Xavier's champions from Craig of the Great, Jasper from Steven Universe, Mikado Santian and his partner Azusa Shiratori, better known as the Golden Pair from Ranma 1/2, Lucas from the 1989 movie The Wizard.
Lucas, darling!
Continuing this roll call, we have both Casey Jones from the 1987 and 2012 versions of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Cindy Slam from Mucha Lucha, Punching Judy and her sister Punching Trudy from OKKO Let's Be Heroes, Dash from The Incredibles, Gabra the Toadoni from the kaiju film All Monsters Attack, better known as Godzilla's Revenge, Bree Lincoln and Chad Dixon from Codename Kids Next Door, Malin and the rest of the Derby Taunts from the 2016 Powerpuff Girls reboot, Genghis the Lion from the Wacky World of Tex Avery, the Greasers from Cat Dog, and Prudence, better known as the Junk Food Kid from Rugrats.
Damn, that is one HE double hockey sticks of a lineup you have there, Beckers.
Oh, we Madame LeBlanc, with this new team of athletic brawlers on our side, we hope to ward off a lot of the Prude's stronger forces. Why, I was thinking of even using the Pulp and Petty's mop to make up our team for the next Laugh Olympics and call it the Sissy Sensationals.
Yeah, why, you could even get some of the more sports savvy members of the Raffy Republic to make up some of this up and coming athletic assembly as well, Sissy by Sweet.
Oh, yes, indeed, that would make it truly sensational.
Jeez, tone it down, will ya, Raffy?
Oh, maybe. Now there's a sexy sports team I wouldn't mind watching. Why, it's making me jizz in my undies just thinking about it.
Yeah, that's my brother, always bringing the term hot tamale to a whole new meaning. Why, it's no wonder they call us wetbacks.
Get it?
Well, at any rate, with that many bad arses on your side, I doubt anyone will be messing with Sissy and her liberation operation anytime soon. Why, you may even keep those Repulsa rejects from coming after them for stealing some of their former members, Hohaya.
Oh yes, I'm sure that Bandora Bimbo would probably even want to come after me after what I did to her butthurt little blue friend. But she wouldn't dare, ha ha ha. And speaking of which, Sandra, you'd be interested to know that in addition to providing extra protection for Sissy and her foot-fighting entourage, the Becky Brigade is also dedicated to stopping those no-good shit-stained cunts who do bad things for the sake of spreading that hurt across the community. Heck, I gave a kid a wedgie just for littering in the episode Salvador Doggy, so you know that despite my tough girl exterior, I'm actually a good egg. So with that said, after everything we've been through together in this video, getting to know one another on both a professional and biblical level, I, Becky the bipolar bad brawler Big Bucks Blickenstorfer, would like to extend to you an invitation to join us in the Becky Brigade in addition to your current standing in the Darkwing Den. You'll have twice the action, twice the excitement and twice the freedom to express yourself the way it was meant to be. No clear indication that I am a hidden member of the Bundy family intended. There are enough rumors about me already after all.
I screwed that blue bastard!
So anyways, Sandra, what do you say?
Me, pull double booty in the Becky Brigade? Well, now that you mention it, that does sound like the uncle fucking business, alright. And being an extreme sports buff myself, I feel like this swell subdivision would be right up my alley. Besides, like you said, Becky, we did share an experience on a very intimate level, and I'd like to keep that going for sure. Wink.
Oh yeah, I was hoping you would say that, Sandra. Welcome aboard, sexy.
Well then, I guess this means we'll be enjoying the best of both worlds after all. Wouldn't you say, Miss LeBlanc?
Oui, Sandra, sure. I guess this means you'll be fighting the good fight and phytophobia and other such brutish locations as part of my swell soul revolution in some way.
Yeah, I guess you're right about that, Miss Delmas. Well, Raffi, I guess you can quit hoping, cause you finally got me, haha.
Oh, see, Sandra, me animal fucking amigo. I knew I would someday!
Bag, not only did I get the main protagonist of this short-lived but swell Nicktoon spin-off show, but I'm gonna be joining a subdivision to a freedom fighter group in the bargain. All in all, I'd say this raid journey was an unadulterated suck-ha-ha-ha success. OHE double hockey sticks, this all sounds so fur-fondling, feather-rustling, neko-member-thrusting, doggy-style insertion, be it giving and or receiving, shit-eating, fat-shaming, rumor-spreading, joke-chuckling, train-splunking, guitar-stroking, poopy-cummy or whatever floats your boat, pizza-gnashing, own face fear-inducing, environmental quiz-spouting, ostrich-charming, zoophile orgy-commencing, life-sized love-katana-polishing, demonic she-male-climaxing, obscure YouTube poop and outdated spiaconia reference-making, being in total agreement that Nickelodeon is an evil conglomerate network, and even if by some miracle they brought the show back, it probably wouldn't be as good as its first run and may even make it worse. In fact, hashtag better yet, don't release the Casa Grande season 4. Sometimes it's better just to fade out than to burn away. Or something along those lines. Dilda's shopping soap dropping turn you into a fur-lusting freak show in half a picosecond, mega meow meow swell in the slender pussy, haha pussy. I think I'll go to Great Lakes City and do all of this.
Oh no, you fucking don't. You didn't think you could wrap things up this easily, did you, Miss LeBlanc?
Sucker Blue? And just who is this?
I remember. It's Luke.
What the? Luke? Oh fuck me, just when I was about to get my happy ending, pun intended, this no good prude hoser shows up.
Oh my, is that someone we should all be worried about?
I think that's the vibe I'm getting here, Bobby.
Yeah, even Becky looks surprised to see this guy.
Whoa, this is totally awkward. What's my prude cousin doing here?
Well, I don't know, but he ain't gonna get away with it, whatever. Hold on, did you say cousin?
It's not over yet!
Well, folks, it would appear that my old Cosmos High skateboard rival Luke has shown up at the last minute to cause some additional trouble and further extend this ghost to video, which has gotten my fellow sick fucks in an uproar for sure. But does Ronnie Anne have another swell trick up her sleeve to counteract this threat? And will the rest of us be able to take on Luke and his sinister circle jerk?
Find out in the fluent conclusion of the Central of One Ghost to Video collaboration special. I'm Yama Teaching on the Panel Pirates. Oh, shiver me timbers, it feels like an eternity since I got to say that still like you know. No. By the way, Marini, you were so right about this team homeland lover you were telling me about earlier. Why this scratchy looking bug is making my rubber plank go extra squidgy at the mere sight of him? But anyways, Mr. Team Owner.
Nakama ni nareyo.
Oh yes, my sexy rubber man. If it means getting back with my sweet bunion boo Maria, then I'll join whatever gig you got going for me.
Oh yes, I was hoping you'd say the T-bone. It'll be just like old times, alright.
Oh yes, me you hearties. We'll be making a slow time of it for sure. Now let's get back to the sounds of sunny and set sail to Roy Woods for our next piece of bunion booty.
Damn it, I finally make it here to Great Lakes City and I still can't find that damn skate park, and those people just left before I could get some directions out of them. Sigh, looks like I won't be meeting up with Sandra anytime soon at this rate. Erg.
Well, as long as you're sticking around, fella, why don't you come join me and some of my girlfriends back at the GLC Zoo, and we'll help you take a load high, a load off. What do you say?
Well, now that you mentioned it, I could rest for a bit, haha.
Nay, have a fee.
Nay, have a fee.
Nay, have a fee.
Nay,
Oh, sweet Lilith. I knew we were called in about a domestic disturbance, but this is fucking ridiculous.